Have you ever been outside metal detecting, just minding your own business, and then been approached by a beautiful girl who has asked,
"So, how does a metal detector work?"
No, me neither. But after this video, you will know how to answer if that ever happens. Hey everyone, welcome to True Vikings. If you're new to the channel, my name is Joel, and today we're gonna talk about how a metal detector works. I usually get asked the question that, "Hey Joel, what is the best metal detector ever?" And my answer is always, the best metal detector is the one you know how to use and you know how it works. Well, I never say that because I just came up with that one. But never mind, different metal detectors work in various ways, but I'm gonna tell about the basics of how they usually work. A metal detector contains this coil. There's two different coils or wires going around this one, and one of them is the transmitter coil. When electricity flows through this coil, an electromagnetic field is created all around this coil. And when you sweep around the ground, the electromagnetic field follows with the coil. If you move the coil or metal detector over a metal object, the electromagnetic field that is created affects the atoms inside this metal object. In fact, it changes how the electrons move. Electrons are the tiny particles that orbit atoms. The metal detector creates some electrical activity inside the metal object, and when there is electricity inside a metal object, it also creates electromagnetism. So when you move the coil over a metal object, the electromagnetic field that comes from the coil creates also an electromagnetic field around this metal object. It's this second magnetic field that this metal detector picks up. A metal detector also contains a different coil here that is called the receiver coil, and when it picks up a second magnetic field from this metal object, that receiver coil transports it to the circuit here and the loudspeakers that make those cool beep sounds. Okay, so let me explain this in five easy steps. First, we have a battery here that activates the transmitter circuit that is built inside this panel. And that passes the electricity along this cable to the transmitter coil. And the electricity passing through this transmitter coil creates an electromagnetic field. And when you sweep this detector over a metal object, the electromagnetic field will go right through this metal object. The electromagnetic field creates an electric current flow running around or through this object. This flowing electrical current will create another electromagnetic field that goes around this object. That second electromagnetic field cuts through the receiver coil, and that receiver coil transports it to the receiver circuit that makes those beautiful sounds. Then we can discuss about different kinds of metal detectors. Magnetic fields are produced by changing electrical fields which oscillate in particular frequencies. Different frequencies give better or worse results depending on what kind of soil you're searching on, what kind of metal you're looking for, and how deep in the ground the metal object is. Although metal detectors work basically in the same way, by converting electricity to magnetism and magnetism to electricity, they come anyway in three different types. The simplest one is the very low frequency that is suitable for every basic metal detecting or treasure hunting needs or purposes. There is also the PI or the pulse induction metal detectors that use higher frequencies and pulsed signals. They can generally pick up objects much deeper than the very low frequency detectors. But the pulse induction detectors are not that discriminating and they are not that widely used. The third type of detector is the full band spectrum detector, or the FBS, that uses multiple frequencies at the same time. And this one, the Minelab Equinox 800, you could say is a FBS detector. You could say it uses several slightly tuned detectors at the same time. Then we can talk about this question that I get asked all the time if I'm outside metal detecting, and that is, how deep can a metal detector go? There's no exact answer to this, unfortunately, because it depends on so many reasons, including the size and the shape of the metal object that is buried. Bigger things are of course easier to detect than the small ones. And of course the orientation of the object plays a big role. That if we have a coin and it lies flat on the ground, it's easier to detect than a coin that is lying sideways. And actually the age of the object plays a role also. That if the object has been longer in the ground, it has corroded more, and that way it's more difficult to find. And then we have the nature of the soil or sand that you're detecting on. That plays a big role as well. And then of course the last point is what kind of metal detector you have. If you have a single frequency or a multi-frequency, so that is important. Generally speaking, a metal detector works at maximum depth of 20 to 50 centimeters. I hope you all like this educational video of how a metal detector works. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button and smash that subscribe button and the bell also, that you don't miss any of our amazing content to come. And see you in the next one.